And now we will do electric field due to sheet charge distribution. Here is a sheet. This sheet may be a paper sheet, metal sheet, this board, earth, or it may be sky, anything. But the distribution is plain here. So let us say here are the charges distributed. Okay, this is a infinitely large sheet. We don't even know how much is the charge on this. Then how do we measure charge? The answer is we take a unit area and measure the charge. This is unit area, this one by one. Whatever is the charge in this, that term we will use as the charge on this. That is known as areal charge density. Areal charge density. This areal charge density, we will use the term. Here we had a symbol lambda. What was this? Linear charge density. This is areal charge density, and this is denoted by, okay, word, this is letter sigma. So this will be given by sigma, and it's very useful. Till you study physics, you will be using this. So what is sigma? Areal charge density, that is charge per unit area. Sigma is any charge in the measurement in certain area, then charge per unit area is sigma. Remember this relation. Okay, so this is measurement of charge, and now we can make electric field like this. How? We take a very small area. This small area is dA, small area. It is as small as a point. If it is as small as a point, then we have a liberty to use formula for point charge, electric field due to point charge for this area dA, and that very small electric field due to this small area will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge upon r square. How much will be the charge on this? The answer is sigma. On one area the charge is sigma, so on dA area the charge will be dA into sigma. So how much will be the charge here? Sigma into dA. This is electric field due to sigma in the area dA. Then what will be the total electric field due to sheet charge? So this will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught integrated on both sides. This will become E, and this will be integration sigma dA upon r square. So this is expression. Now what will be the shape? The answer is, if this is the sheet, the electric field in this direction, this direction, this direction, and all other components are cancelled out in this way and here in this direction, right? Like you have seen a toothbrush. On the toothbrush we see all the bristles coming out. Boot polish brush, all the bristles coming in this direction, same bristles coming in this direction. That is the shape of electric field in case of a sheet. If we see a side view, the side view will show like this. This is electric field, and this is what? Sheet, side view. So this is expression. This is how it will look, and sigma is will be our measurement, charge per unit area. Okay, now we have done three shapes. One is point charge, one is line charge, and one is areal charge. We are introduced to point charge Q, line charge lambda, sheet per unit area charge sigma, and there is one more. That is, if we have a cloud and there is a charge all in that. So that charge, how do we measure? It is distributed all over volume. If charge is distributed all over volume, how we will calculate the electric field? Do we use a point formula, line formula, or a sheet formula? Answer, none of them. We have to use a formula which is for volume only. And for volume, we have a fourth quantity of measuring the charge. In volume, again, the distances are different at different places. If this is a football-like volume and all over the charges are distributed, it is a cloud which is a non-conductor. If it is a non-conductor, the charges, though they repel each other, but they will not come to the surface. Why they don't come to the surface? Because it is a non-conductor. Okay, non-conductor, it will not come. So these are all filled up in this. If it is a conductor, they will come here and it will act like a surface. That will be aerial charge density. But in non-conductor, the charges are filled up here. How do we measure? And for this, we have taken another term, and that term is charge per unit volume. We will call it volumetric charge density. And this volumetric charge density, we have given the symbol rho. Rho. What is rho? If the total charge divided by total volume, this gives us the term rho. Now, the electric field due to this at a distance r. This at a distance r we have measured in this. Here the distance is r and we want to measure here. But this has got different direction. This has got different direction. This has got different direction. So r is also different. We cannot use the formula for point charge. Then we don't have any other formula. What do we do? Again, we do the same technique. We take a very small volume, as small as a point. How much is the volume of this? Answer is, this volume is dV, very small volume. How much will be charge on this? So one volume has charge rho, so dV volume will have charge rho into dV. This is a very small charge in this. Now, it is such a small volume that we can treat it as a point. If we treat it as a point, then we are permitted to use formula for point charge. In that case, what will be the electric field due to this point volume? That is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. In the place of charge, we will write rho dV. Now it is in point shape, upon r square. This. And this will create a very small part of electric field. Another small part will be given by this, another by this, another by this, another by this, and total electric field will be integration of this, integration of this. Integration of this is total electric field for the full volume, and this is constant, it will not be integrated, and rho dV upon r square. This we will integrate for the complete value of volume. So this is our expression for electric field due to volume. So what will be the shape? The shape is always normal to the surface. Normal to surface. On this side, this side, coming up, going down, everywhere. It is normal to the surface. This angle will always be right angle at every place. So that will be the shape of the electric field due to volumetric charge density. So we have gone through four terms to denote the charges. One term is Q, that is point charge. If it is distributed in a very long line, we cannot measure the full charge. So our method of measurement is charge per unit length, and for that we are using lambda. This is charge per unit length or linear charge density. If the charge is distributed over a sheet, then we use the term sigma, which is aerial charge density. And if it is in terms of volume distribution, then we use, this is rho. Rho is what? Volumetric charge density. So we have point charge with formula Q upon R square. We have linear charge, lambda dl upon R square. We have aerial conductivity, sigma dA upon R square, and volumetric, rho dV upon R square. You will see there is a symmetry in all of them, and those are integration of point charge divided by square of the R. This is the matter. Now, this is purely mathematical equations and a method to tell you that every time electric field will be different for different type of distributions. If the different type of distributions are there, the electric field at a distance R will be different for each distribution. And after that, there is a very peculiar distribution which is very, very much prevalent in our nature. That is, there is one positive charge and one negative charge. And this is one set of charge, one positive and one negative, no net charge. Does it make an electric field? Answer is yes. This makes a positive, this makes a negative, but even then there is a net electric field, and these things are known as dipoles. Yes, you know dipole, very much you know dipole, because every day you are using it. NaCl. Okay, you are using common salt. This is positive charged particle, this is negatively charged particle, and this whole sodium chloride molecule is a dipole. So in the next class, we will study what are dipoles, what are the effectiveness of dipoles, how do they make their electric field, and other quantities related to dipoles, because this is linked to our life.